Welcome, everyone. Hey, I'm just feeling the wind in my hair on my cool vintage scooter here. This is an e-scooter. 1,000 watt, 48 volt front hub drive motor on this thing here. Reason why I built this is, well, I was goofing around on the interwebs and I saw this, a 1945 safety cycle scooter. And then I saw the Schwinn shuffle scooter and I said, hey, let's make something that's kind of like it. I mean, it don't look exactly like it, but hey, it looks fun. It's got the little basket on the back there. You got panels that are similar. So let's do it, okay? I'll have links down below showing you where I got all the stuff to put on it. And hey, did I tell you we got air horns on this thing? Yeah, buddy. Okay, so I started with a Schwinn shuffle scooter. Has 26-inch front wheel, 20-inch rear wheel, with a caliper brake. We're going to keep the rear wheel. We're going to get rid of the front wheel because we're putting a hub drive on it. So in order to build it, I had to strip this thing down butt naked. Yep, then I got out my cutting tools and we cut this thing right in half, okay? Then what I did is I took some 3/4-inch tubing and I stretched it 14 inches. I used a 5/8-inch solid bar for a plug there to help with the join. That way I've got a good solid connection there. Now this is not going to be strong enough here, just the inner frame like it is, so I added an outer frame of 1-inch, very thick-walled, 0.120 wall thickness tubing on it to give it an extra frame there, and I did a ladder sort of arrangement to help stiffen the frame up, okay? So, I then built the frame area for the seating that holds both of my batteries as well. So, not only is it going to hold the weight of my fat butt, it's going to hold my batteries, all right? So, speaking of that fat butt, we need something cushy for it to sit on. Got some thick foam, wrapped it with some of that pleather, crocodilian, reptile-looking stuff there, stapled it together, and there you go. You got a seat fit for my fat butt. I took the back of the seat off. I didn't like that. Then I used some craft paper to make templates, which I used to cut out my panels on the bike, drilled holes, popped rivets in it to hold the majority of it together. Then I drilled holes through the panel and put screws into it, into the frame underneath. So the power is a 1,000 watt, 48 volt front hub motor. Instead of the 4-inch tires that the fat tires run with, I used a 3-inch beach bum tire. Now, in order to accept the new front wheel, we needed new forks. And the cool thing about these forks is they've got disc brake tab, so we can run a disc brake on this here and have some good stopping power. So a 48 volt 20 amp hour battery set me back about $350. Putting everything together was pretty easy. The directions that came with the e-bike kit were spot on. Everything fit together flawlessly. Got all my wiring underneath here, so you've got the motorcycle battery under there. You can see the horn. I've got the switch for the headlight and the taillight that I run. I bought a motorcycle LED headlight. Time to feel the wind in my hair. Hey, this is a fun little bike. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you enjoyed the video, give me a big fat thumbs up. Mash that subscribe button. And hey, wear your helmet. Take care.